Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Optimizer. So we are right now in the series of part design. So in last series we have discussed about different sketches exercise, and in this series we are dealing with the part design. Okay, so in last video we have seen some simple part design models. So from this video we are going to start with little bit complicated things. Okay, so in this we are going to see this frame block. So first, as we have discussed, we are going to start with two things, that is we need to decide number of steps required to model this part, and second one, in from which direction we should start. Okay, so for example suppose this is x direction, this one is y direction. So for this part we are going to start from x direction, so that if you draw this profile we can pad it by 48, so majority of part is going to be covered during this pad. Okay, so if you start from y direction, then it is very typical number of steps required are larger. Okay, so let us discuss how many number of steps are required for this part. So if you consider this, first we are going to pad this, so that is first part. In second part, this fillet and these holes are there. In third part, this pocket is there, and fourth part will be some fillet. So in 4 to 5 steps we are going to complete this design. So let us start. I am going to start from this. I am going to draw this profile. So this profile I am going to draw. So there are two circles and a rectangle is joined to this one. So let us start. So I am going to select this plane, that is YZ plane. Click on sketch, select plane. Now let us start. So firstly I am going to take origin here I am going to take as origin. So first circle, second circle, and after that I am going to draw one rectangle here like this. Okay, or you can draw directly profile also. So let us draw with profile so that more number of commands will cover. So I'm going to start from this point like this. So I have drawn this part. Okay, now secondly I'm going to draw this part also. So one more rectangle I'm going to draw. So you can draw a rectangle, or again you can start with this horizontal line. Okay, now you can trim all the unnecessary parts. So just go to quick trim and you just trim this part. We don't require this part also, this part and this part. So overall structure of this we have drawn. Now you can give the dimension. So total length of this is 107. The diameter of this outer circle is R30 and inner circle is we can consider this as a 538. Okay, so just give dimensions, double click on this constraint. So this is R30, correct, and this one is 538. So just go to diameter and just give it 38. Okay, now total overall length, so from this to this, this length is 107, correct, this length is 107. So 107, so just bring this like, just drag that line here and this line like this. Okay, now you need to provide the height. So this height is 11 and this total height is 41. Okay, so you need to define that 11 and 41. So it is 41, 11, and from this part if you just see, from this to this end is 51, total 51 distance is there. So from this to this it is 51. Okay, and now we need to define the width of this one strip, that is again 11. So this one is 11. So this is how we have converted this sketch into fully constrained. So we need to pad it. Okay, so if you just see, total 48 mm pad is there. So I'm going to do a mirror extent. So pad here we need to select a mirror extent, and here you need to define 24. So 24 plus 24, so total 48 mirror extent will be there like this. Okay, now I'm going to apply some fillet. So if you just see, this fillet is, the outer diameter is R30, so R30 R30, and again this one we can assume this is around R8. Okay, so just go to fillet. I'm going to select this edge, and just enter as 13, that is R13. Okay, now again you can take a fillet, this and this, 8, okay, or 8 or whatever it you can take as per your requirement. And now these holes are 22 mm center distance is there, and diameter of that hole is 510. So let us draw that one. So for that you need to select this face. So just click on this sketch, select this face. Now you can draw first and second circle, okay, and you need to select, you need to make these two circles symmetric about this vertical axis. So first circle, second circle, by pressing control you need to select this, just go here and make them symmetry. Okay, now you can give a dimension. So this is 510, diameter is 10, and center distance, as we know, it is 22. Center distance is 22. And one more thing, so from this it is around 13 mm inside, because it is concentric with this circle, and concentric this with this circle. So from this it is at 13 mm. So just put 13 mm, just enter exit workbench, and just pocket it up to last, pocket up to next or up to last, you can select, and just click on OK. Okay, so second step we are completed. First step is pad of this, second step is this pocket and fillet. Now third step is here there is one small slot that we are going to take. So for that, if you just see, this is total, this depth is around, this diameter is 13 and the center distance is 25 from this bottom side. Okay, so it is exactly at the center. So sketch, select this face, and now I'm going to use elongated hole like this, and it will be like this. Okay, now you can give the dimensions. So these dimensions already they are defined, that is 13, that is 6.5. okay, 6.5 radius we are defined. So from this center is 25. Okay, and you can define this center distance so that we can convert that into fully constrained, and you can pocket it up to next, pocket up to next, just click on OK. So don't go for up to next, up to last, just go to dimension, and whatever the thickness is there, so total thickness is 11, so you can define 11, just click on OK. So this is last step. Now you need to provide a fillet. So fillet are around 2 mm fillets are there. So these fillets are provided here and other things. So just go to fillet again, select this step, whatever the edges, sharp edges are there. So just fillet, provide a fillet of 2 mm. Okay, now one more thing is, there is small hole here of diameter 5, so we need to provide this one. So for that you just go to sketch again, select this, okay, select this top plane, that is this plane we are going to select, just click on the sketch, and here you need to draw one circle of 5 mm, correct, and just click on exit workbench. Okay, so now just pocket it up to next, you can pocket it, and just click on OK. So this is how you need to finish total part. So what we have learned from this video, so firstly you need to decide the number of steps to require to model that part, Secondly, you need to decide direction from which you need to start the model. Okay, I hope you understood this. If you like our video, please subscribe our channel and stay tuned to this channel so that you will learn more and more. So thank you. We will meet on next video. Thank you.